In this video, you will learn introduction to blob storage and then installing the Azure SDK for .NET, and then we'll go ahead and create the MVC application, that means wave role to upload blobs, for example images or video maybe, and delete the blobs. And at the end of this video, you will learn how to push your application, wave role application and storage to the Azure. So let's begin with introduction to blob storage. Windows Azure provides various cloud-enabled storage services, and blob is one of them. Blob stands for binary large object, which means unstructured data that typically includes image, document, audio, video, or other multimedia objects. Now a question arises here, why we use blob storage services in the cloud? The blob storage services provides by Windows Azure is manageable, scalable, and high available data in the cloud. That's why we store blob storage in the cloud. Now let's learn how to install Azure SDK for .NET framework. In order to develop Azure cloud enabled applications, we need to install its SDK. There are various ways to download and install the SDK. Either you can go to the website windowsazure.com/en-us/downloads and download the Windows Azure SDK for .NET from there, or the best way using Visual Studio IDE is, I'm going to show you. You just need to open Visual Studio and do a file new project, and in the Visual C sharp section select the cloud. You will find this Get Windows Azure SDK for Visual C sharp. Just click on OK button, and this process will create a Windows Azure One cloud project, and it will also have a .html file. You can see it is already opened. Here you can see a button, download Windows Azure SDK for .NET. Click on this button. Once you click on that button, it will take you on this web page. Here you will find install the SDK link. If you click on that link, a dialog will appear, and here you just need to click on install button, and then it will go through some processes and start installing and downloading the SDK. Once you successfully installed the Azure SDK for .NET framework, you will again have to do a file new project, and you will find a Windows Azure Cloud Services project inside the cloud section, Visual C Sharp language. You just need to hit OK here to create a cloud enabled project. In this dialog, select ASP.NET MVC for wave role. You could select any worker role, queue, etc. What are wave role, worker role and queue? You will see it in just a bit. But for the sake of simple blob demo, selecting ASP.NET MVC wave role will work. At the end, hit OK button here. Now before understanding the projects already created in Solution Explorer, let's understand what is web role. Web role in Windows Azure are special purpose and provide a dedicated Internet Information Services IIS web server used for hosting front-end web applications. You can quickly and easily deploy web application to web roles and then scale your compute capability up or down to meet your requirement. Now what is worker role? So worker role are process that can do some work. For example, automatically compressing uploaded image, do a stop whenever something changes in your database, and get new messages from queue and process them. Now again, what is queue? Queue is something that contains set of messages, and all messages must be in queue. Always keep in mind, web roles, worker roles and queue are actually virtual machines running on the cloud. As you can see, I am showing you the images I already have. Now let's go ahead and create the project. I'll do file, new project, and in this dialog I will select Visual C Sharp and then cloud. You can see here Windows Azure Cloud Services. Hit OK here. In this dialog, let's select ASP.NET MVC for web role. You already know what is web role. Web role is just a front end application UI that appears to user. Let's select it and click on this button, and here hit OK. Now in this dialog, just select Internet application and hit OK. It will create a MVC 4 web application with internet application template. And also a Windows Azure Cloud project. You can see here in Solution Explorer, I already have Windows Azure 3 project and also a MVC web role project. So this is just a regular MVC with internet application template. You will notice a new file here, webrole.cs file. This file contains the entry point settings of MVC application. You need this file when MVC running in the cloud services. The information written in this file executes before the execution of global.asx file here. So we use this file to configure what to do before starting the web application. Means you can see here a onStart method. Now rest everything in this project will be familiar to you if you know MVC web application. The second project is Windows Azure project. This is actually a cloud project. Inside the Windows Azure project, you will find a role folder. In the role folder, you will find MVC web role. In case if we have worker role, you will see here MVC worker role. Open this file. So this file contains all the information required to run the application, means web role, on local development server and also to take it to the cloud services. Here you will find various sections like configuration, settings, endpoint, local storage, certificates and caching. Now look at the settings section. Here you will see add setting button. By using this button you can add connection string or normal string name value type pairs. Currently you can see here a name and its type to connection string and its value. If you look at this value, you will see use development storage equals true. Means if we run this project now, the local development storage will be used. So at the time of deployment of this application to the cloud, we have to change this value. Now let's go ahead and add a setting. I will name this setting image storage account connection and its type to connection string, and the value will be click on this button and select Windows Azure Storage Emulator. Now when we will publish this application to cloud, we will select manually entered credential or maybe your subscription. So here for now, just select Windows Azure Storage Emulator and hit OK. You will again see here use development storage equal to true, means this application will use our local storage for development purpose. Now, in order to call the storage account and create the container, you need a class in MVC project. Just go ahead and add a class here by name blob storage services and hit add. Now, let's go ahead and add a method that will get the cloud blob container information public cloud blob container. Here hit control plus period and this will import a namespace, and the name of the method will be get cloud blob container. Just to save the time, I am going to copy paste the code. You need to import couple of namespaces here, so make sure you have all. Now let's understand the code written in this method. Using this cloud storage account, I am trying to connect the configuration setting that we just have provided here, which is image storage account connection that will store the image on development storage, and that name I am using here, inside the get configuration setting value. And again here I am using cloud blob client object to create the cloud blob service client. And again here I am using cloud blob container to check if there is any container by name my images. And inside the if condition here I am checking if there is a blob container. If it is not there, just go ahead and create a new blob container with name my images, and it will return the blob container. Blob container is nothing but the container name. Container is just like folder on the cloud. So I'm returning the reference of blob container that we just have created, or maybe it may be already there. So it will not create a new my images container. It will just use the existing one. That's why I am using a create if not exist method here. Now we have a storage account and container setup already. Now we can go ahead and use them inside the controllers. So let's go ahead and open the controller. Close all these files. I'm going to add new action methods inside this home controller. Just go ahead and type blob storage services. This class is nothing but the blob storage services that we just created here. Now again create public action result upload method. And it's post version also. Now inside the upload method, create here cloud blob container, insert the namespace equals blob storage services, the object of my class, blob storage services class, get cloud blob container, and then list all the name of blobs and loop through the list blob items in blob container dot list blobs blob dot add blob item dot URI dot to string and return these blobs to the view page. There are two upload action results. First one will list all the available blobs URI in the container and return it to the view page to display all the blobs. Means if we upload the blobs which is image, it will list all the image and loop through the images and return all the URI of images to the view page. Now let's go ahead and implement its post version. Means user will be able to upload its blob. For this, I'll write http posted file base image. Means it will collect the posted file information, and if image has content length greater than 0, it will do following actions. What it will do is cloud blob container equals underscore blob storage services dot get cloud blob container, and then cloud block blob equals blob container dot block blob references image dot file name of the image, file name of all the images, then blob dot upload file from a stream image dot input stream, and once it upload the file, return the user, means redirect to action, to action upload. So this will accept the posted file which is image and upload it to the blob container, and at the end this will redirect the same view to make it recently upload image visible to user. Okay, now we need one more method to delete the blobs, so let's go ahead and create it. So public string delete image. So in order to delete the image, we just need to pass the image name. It will have http post label, so URI and its object URI new URI and name of the image, string file name equal to system dot io dot path dot get file name URI the object and its local path, and again cloud blob container equals underscore blob service dot get cloud container, and cloud blob block blob blob equals blob container dot get block blob reference by file name, and delete that blob and return the information string message to user file. Now let's understand this method. You can see this method will accept name as a parameter and return a string message which is a string, and it will return file deleted. Name is nothing but the URI of the image. URI means the complete address of image, means http://website address/ its container account name, and then container, and then image name.jpg or png something. So in order to know the actual name of the image, means image name.jpg, we need to use uri.localpath. Then we will use this file name to get the reference of the blob here, and at the end we will delete the file here, blob.delete, and return the message to user that file has been deleted. Now we have all the required method. The only thing we are left with is the view of this upload action result. So right click here and select add view and hit add here. Now let's add some code here. Upload image, name it to upload image, create a paragraph tag and create a form section using, I'm using Razor syntaxes here, html.beginForm, and this is my action result which is inside home controller, and form method will be post new int type equals multimedia slash form data, and inside this scope let's add some html tags, input and type will be file. This will allow us to upload the image and its name will be image, and again a button type submit and value will be okay. So this will create a form for us. When we hit upload button here, it will go and call the upload method which has post label, means it will call this method. So it will allow, it will just upload the image to the blob. Now once we uploaded the image, we need to display all the images available in the container. So again I will write a for each loop using Razor syntaxes. I'm using model here because the get version of the upload method will return blob. Blob is just model here. Let's create a list here, and li should be always inside ul. Okay, so inside li just create a image tag, img tag, and its src will be nothing but item, and alt alternative message we can display image here, and let's set its width to 100 and its height to 100. And now to delete the image, let's create a link here, aid equals name this also item. Item is nothing but the URL, complete URL, means including www.jpg. So the name of this link will be, so the ID of this link will be the URL of the image, complete URL. And inside the controller, we will extract its name from the URI using uri.localpath. So item href equals nothing, and on its click, we will handle a JavaScript method, delete image, and it will take a parameter which is also item, and write here delete so that user can see delete link. And just to style this list, let's style list style type to none to, so that we cannot see any bullet sign before the images, and its padding to zero, so that all the space before the image will set to zero. Now we need to handle this JavaScript method call. So create a script tag here and create a function by name delete copy, and it will take a parameter item. Item is nothing the complete URL of the image, and var URL equals where to post, means we will use here home dot delete image, means this URL will have the address of inside the home controller delete image method that we just set up here. Now call a post method here, post, and pass URL, means inside the home controller call a delete image, and this will have also a value item. Item is nothing the complete URL, and function data windows dot location, means after deleting the image, redirect to a new page, href windows dot location dot href to home slash upload. Now we are all set to run this application. Now it will trigger the Windows Azure emulator to store the blobs on local machine, and it is running now. We'll just go on the home and then upload action, hit enter here. So you can see my project is running. So click on browse button, select the image and try to upload any image, select open and click upload. So there is a quick mistake. Let's stop the application and go ahead, and you can see here multimedia, it should be multi-part, and another mistake here slash. Now run the application and browse to home upload view page, again select the image and click on upload button, and you can see there is a image uploaded. Now again select another image and click on upload. You can see we are successfully uploading the image. Now try to delete the image, click on delete. You can see I can delete the image and upload the image. Now let's learn the last type, publishing the application, and it's a storage to Windows Azure Cloud. Okay, before publishing a storage and MVC application web role on the cloud, let's look at the local development server and see what's happening here. When you open Server Explorer and try to expand Windows Azure storage here, you will see here development. And inside the development, you will see here a blob. Look, I have already a working solution here. So you can see here a cloud. This is development storage and this is cloud storage. I am already connected with my cloud storage. So I can delete it here for now. So we have only development cloud here, development storage. We can click on blob and you can see there is a container, my images. If we right click on this my images and click on view blob container, we can see all the images uploaded. Right now there is no images because all the images we uploaded we deleted. So let's run the application again and try to upload another image so that we can see here some result. You can see here a cloud is just triggering on. Try to move home upload page and upload any image here. Click on upload and let's stop this execution and again click to open my images and you can see there are images. In the same way, if you open here, you will find a emulator is running. We can right click here and we can see there is a show storage emulator UI option. Click on this. You will see here a storage emulator which has blob, queue and table storage service management already running. We can here stop the services, reset the services here. If we reset the services here, all the images we uploaded on local blob storage will be deleted. So close this here. Now let's go quickly on Windows Azure portal, online portal, and quickly create a storage account by name blob storage demo. So you can see I am on Windows Azure management portal. I already logged in. I have MSDN subscription. So just click on new here and move to data storage and click on quick create storage account. So I will type blob storage demo here and check if it is available here. Select the location. I will select here East Asia and hit on create a storage account. It will create a blob storage demo storage account. Now you can see blob storage demo account and its status is online. So you just select it and you will see here a option manage access key. Just click on this and it will retrieve a storage account access keys. You just need to copy this storage account name and primary access key. Paste it here. This is my account name and click here to copy, allow access and copied and paste the access key. Okay, now switch back to Visual Studio, close this file and again open Cloud Project MVC web role and inside setting just modify this value which is image storage account CONN. Modify this storage to manually entered credentials and paste the access key here and the storage account name which is blob storage demo and hit OK. And that's it. Now this will store all the blobs in the storage account which is on the cloud. It will go and create a container by name my images and store all the images on the cloud. We can run this application here and check it and you can see there is no image. And if you remember, we had a image but there is no image uploaded here because it is directly connecting to the cloud storage, cloud blob storage. So browse here and again upload a new image here. If we click on upload here, it will upload that image on the cloud. Okay, so we have uploaded a image on the cloud also. Just upload one more here so that we will see the differences. Click on upload And there we go. Close the browser here. Again, switch back to Server Explorer and try to connect the storage. Add a storage new account and manually enter credential here and enter the account name and access key to connect the storage account which is on cloud. This is my account and this is my access key, and hit OK here. And now we have a development storage account and a cloud storage account. If we click on development and right click and click on view, it will display you a single image. But when we open the blob storage demo, which is on the cloud, and if we click view blob container, you will see here two images. So you can easily understand we are connected to the cloud storage now. So for now, we moved our storage account to cloud. Now let's go ahead and push this application, means our web role, to the cloud. For this, right click on MVC web role application and click on publish to Windows Azure. Now in this dialog, you can see credentials are required to connect to your Windows Azure subscription. To get the credential, just click on this link and you will see a file downloaded. Just go and import that file and that's it. I already did this, so I'm going to click on next here, and you can see here cloud services option here. So there is only a single cloud, iTorian. We can create a new cloud services here by name blob cloud services or whatever you wish, and select the location to East Asia or anything else. Click on OK. It will go and create a blob cloud services on the Azure portal. So we can switch back to management portal and click on the cloud services. There is only a iTorian. Just refresh this page, you will see another storage account by name blob cloud storage, and there it is. Switch back to Visual Studio and click on next button here, and again click to publish. So this process will take couple of minutes. You can see the publish started, and the deployment process status you can see here. It will take couple of minutes depending upon the bandwidth of your internet access. Now let's switch back to Windows Azure portal. You can see here a message deploying, and in the Visual Studio there is already a status on progress. Once it's successfully deployed the application, it will automatically open the URL, and again another message running, production running already. And in the Visual Studio the status is still in progress. Now the status changed to completed. So click on this URL and try to browse on the application and upload the images. And for this we need to browse home and then upload view page. And you can see there is two images already available here. Try to delete the images and upload new one. Select the image and hit upload. And you can see everything running okay on the cloud. Application, my web role is on the cloud, and my storage, blob storage, is also on the cloud. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much.